Did you know that according to the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, as many as 23 million Americans hear noise of some type when in fact there's actually none to be heard? This condition is called tinnitus or tinnitus, and unfortunately, it's very common among veterans. Right now, there's no known cure for tinnitus, but scientists at VA's National Center for Rehabilitative Auditory Research are working hard to help veterans cope with its effects. From the roar of jet engines on a carrier deck to the rumble of field artillery, military service has always had more than its share of high decibel assaults on the ear. That helps explain why one of the most common service-connected disabilities among veterans is the auditory impairment known as tinnitus, or tinnitus if you prefer. Either one is correct.
Tinnitus is really any ringing, humming, buzzing, or any other sound in the ears or head that's not caused by an external source. More commonly, I hear things like a high-pitched tone or a hiss. Sometimes it's a low-pitched roar. Can be just about any sound.
Tinnitus can result from blast trauma or simply from prolonged exposure to very loud noises. In either case, its effects range from mildly irritating to incapacitating. The amount of auditory damage depends on the degree that it interferes with sleep, concentration, social interaction, and work.
It's a matter of degree, characteristic of the tinnitus, and the perceived amplitude and loudness of the tinnitus.
Stephen Fausti is director of the VA National Center for Rehabilitative Auditory Research in Portland, Oregon, an advanced facility for auditory research. Much of the work done here currently focuses on managing tinnitus while the search for a cure continues.
And so what we focus on is kind of the next best thing, and that's figuring out how to feel better with the tinnitus still there.
And it's highly predicated upon education and understanding, dealing with the human factor of individuals and their perceptions of what's taking place with them.
VA's efforts to help veterans manage this condition also include the development of improved hearing aids.
And I am the recipient of digital hearing devices, so they tend to mask, in my case, a very large percentage of the tinnitus, the ringing, the constant shh sounds, and I enjoy the freedom of that. Without the hearing devices, on a scale of 1 to 10, I'm probably a 6.
Developing treatment techniques and devices for rehabilitating veterans living with tinnitus is only one part of the mission here in Portland. These VA researchers are also concerned with improving diagnostic techniques, along with helping devise methods to prevent hearing loss from occurring in the first place. VA estimates that as many as 400,000 veterans suffer with tinnitus, and regrettably, that number is on the rise among those who've served in Iraq and Afghanistan. But as you've seen, VA is dedicated to finding effective treatments for this kind of service-connected ailment. If you'd like to learn more about VA's research into treating tinnitus, please visit our website at www.ncrar.research.va.gov.